Alright, let's get to the topic of the video, which are all about fallacies. By definition, fallacies are arguments derived from false logic. They look true, but don't be deceived by it, because these arguments are illogical and invalid. There are so many types of fallacies, but we are going to discuss three: ad hominem, slippery slope, and hasty generalization. Here are some of our real-life examples of these fallacies. Ad hominem is a type of fallacy wherein an argument, belief, or action is either dismissed or accepted depending on someone's personality and his personal background. When I was in 9th grade, me and my classmates and some of their friends decided to run for the elections. During that time, there were two party lists, one coming from us, which are STEM students who were smart, goal-driven, and really has the desire to move a needle into the school and make some changes. The other one came from the regular section, which mainly composed of dancers, influencers. Some of them just knows how to dance in TikTok, and I don't know. After the elections, after the campaign, after the voting, guess what happened? When the results came in, none of us from the party list won. All of the people who won from the elections were basically those people from the regular party list. Amazing! The famous people won. And yeah, to no surprise, when they are now serving their terms, they failed. They didn't do much. They failed to do anything. And the rest of the school year suck. Our grade 10 days were just plain bad, boring, and nothing else was added there because the officials never made anything. Well, I'm not going to, you know, slander the names of those people, but I think we could have done much more better if we won the elections. This only showed that the famous ones, even though they don't have any talents or they don't have any skills to run and manage a government body, have the best odds into winning the election. Voters only judge the capabilities of an aspirant according to their clout and not to their potential and wits.
The slippery slope is an argument that concludes that there would be an effect after effect based in your main action. If you constantly get low score on a test, the possibility of you failing is definite. If you would fail, you would not be able to graduate, and people will start to have disappointments towards you.
A hasty generalization is a claim based on few examples rather than substantial proof. Arguments based on hasty generalizations often don't hold up due to a lack of supporting evidence. The claim might be true in one case, but that doesn't mean it's always true. I got correct answers from the internet, so all information from the internet is true. Back then, I always looked for answers on the internet. But as I grew in age, I noticed there were mistakes on the internet. I remember back then, I searched the internet for the question, is being vegan healthy? And there were many contradictory answers. One site stated that being a vegetarian is healthy. Another site states that being vegetarian will leave you weak because you will be lacking proteins and other essential nutrients found in animals. Because of this, I learned to think critically and look for trusted source of information. I began evaluating whether what I read is true, false, biased, or a fallacy.